Assalamu alaikum viewers. Our today's topic is promoting tourism in Pakistan. This topic has already been discussed in a different way in, I think, lecture number 25 or 26, if I'm not wrong. So we are going to discuss this topic in the form of a presentation on different slides. First, coming to the significance of the topic, why this topic is so significant. It is significant because it can be the topic of the English essay. It can be a question of Pakistan affairs and current affairs in the context of improving economy of Pakistan. That can be one measure. It may be one measure to improve economy of Pakistan, and it may be one measure to among many measures to alleviate poverty in Pakistan. Moreover, it may be a tool to promote soft image of Pakistan. So in the context of in all these topics, this topic is very much significant. This was the topic in 2020. It was essay topic, promoting tourism in Pakistan, opportunities and challenges. So, as a pre-essay notes, we are going to discuss these outline with you, and to enable you to write an essay on this subject. However, the detailed essay has already been given in the playlist of essay writing playlist of this channel. So these are the advantages of tourism. It can promote soft image of Pakistan when the tourists from the foreign countries would visit Pakistan. They would see the natural beauty of Pakistan and they would come to interact with the local population. And certainly there are strengths of our culture and our local people which might impress the foreign tourist, and they would go back with very pleasant memories of our beautiful landscape. And obviously this is going to promote soft image of Pakistan. Second is the contribution of tourism to the GDP of Pakistan. This is explained in this slide. According to the reports released by the World Travel and Tourism Council, which is an international forum set up primarily to conduct research on the economic and social impact of the tourism industry, the direct contribution of travel and tourism to Pakistan's GDP in 2016 was $7.6 US billion, constituting 2.7% of the total GDP. So this figure may be improved by improving the conditions of tourism in Pakistan. Although each country has its own GDP and its own peculiar characteristics of its economy, yet we may have a cursory look of the economies of other countries, like the US travel and tourism industry generated over $1.6 trillion in 2017. In 2016, the tourism sector made a total contribution of around €159 billion to the GDP in Spain. So these comparisons are given with an effort to build the argument that the share of tourism to the GDP of Pakistan may be increased. So there are certain business and employment opportunities. We can quote here the example of Maldives, where around 40% of employment opportunities are created by the tourism sector. So Maldives is an example for Pakistan. The other advantage is promotion of local culture. As I have already stated, that when the foreign tourist would come to interact with the local people, there are many fine things in our culture, hospitality, taking care of the guest. So these things are going to have lasting impact on the minds of the foreign tourists. So we may have an opportunity to promote our local culture. So when the efforts will be made to promote tourism in Pakistan, we would need to develop certain tourist spots which have not been developed yet, like the Gorakh Hill in Dadu, Sindh, and the Fort Monroe in Diji Khan and Galiath. So these tourist spots would be required to be built and developed. Another advantage of promoting tourism in Pakistan would be that when the foreign tourist, having the highest aesthetic sense and civic sense, would interact with the local people, the general public in Pakistan would develop a kind of exposure and civic sense among them. So coming to the opportunities in the tourism industry, there are certain places of scenic beauty like Naran, Kagan, like Saif al-Muluk, Ayubia, Nasia Gali, Murri. There are certain spots like Soon Valley, as I have already narrated, Gorakh Hill, Fort Monroe. These are not only the places of scenic beauty, but they present very fine, very beautiful weather also. And especially in the summer season, these places have very good temperature, and in winter they offer snowfall. So there are certain historical sites which are opportunity, which may be counted as opportunity in the tourism industry. These are Wazir Khan Mosque, Mohabbat Khan Mosque, Lahore Fort, Badshahi Masjid, Wazir Khan Mosque, Rohtas Fort, Begum Shahi Mosque, Hiran Minar, Tomb of Jahangir, and many more. You may explain any one or two or three, depending upon the space in the paragraph, because you have to write all these things in one paragraph, one point, one idea in one paragraph. So I have narrated two or three in detail, like Badshahi Mosque was built by the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb in 1671. The construction of the mosque lasted for 2 years until 1673. Wazir Khan Mosque, located in the city of Lahore and built in 1641 during the reign of the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan. Rohtas Fort is 16th century construction built during the reign of Sher Shah Suri and located near the city of Jhelum in the province of Punjab. You may explain two or three points and then just state other arguments in one or two sentences, and in this way, in a paragraph of 6 to 8 sentences, you may encapsulate all the points. So there are certain archaeological sites which are, again, they are offering opportunity in the tourism industry. These are Katas Raj temples, Koh Diji in district airport, Takht Bhai in Mardan, Mohenjo-daro, Harappa, Sirkap. So you may explain any two or three in your single paragraph, as I have explained. Mohenjo-daro, being one of the largest sites of the Indus Valley civilization, was built around 2500 before Christ and remained undocumented for over 3000 years until archaeologists discovered it in the early 1920s. Harappa, located near Saival city in the province of Punjab, was another city of Indus Valley civilization. Harappa is said to be founded around 2600 before Christ. These are two oldest civilization. Another example is Sirkap, ancient Texla city, whose origin as a city goes back to 1000 before Christ. That is an important city of ancient India. Another example to promote tourism in Pakistan is national monuments. There are certain national monuments which are built to memorize or to symbolize certain historical events, like our historical persons. like Islamic Past Tomb, Islamic Summit Minar, Minare Pakistan, Qaid Azam Residency, Pakistan Monument. So I have explained three in this. Qaid Azam Residency, also called Ziyarat Residency, located in Ziyarat Balochistan, is the place where Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah spent the last few weeks of his life. Pakistan Monument, located in Islamabad, was constructed to symbolize the unity of the Pakistani people. Minare Pakistan, built in 1960s on the site in Lahore, where the All India Muslim League passed the Lahore Resolution on March 23, 1940, the first official commitment for a separate and independent homeland for the Muslims of the subcontinent. So another example are game reserves. Many dignitaries from the Arab countries come to Pakistan to hunt for Bara Bustard. And these places, especially in Rahim Yar Khan and in Thal Desert and Turistan Desert, there are many dozens of game reserves in Pakistan, and they may be used to extract revenue because the dignitaries pay money for the game, and in return they hunt a specified number of birds, and this also regulate and the wildlife hunting, and it is also a tool to preserve the wildlife because the hunting is done in a controlled way. The hunting is regulated and there is no threat to the wildlife survival. There are certain places of religious significance for the followers of other religions too. We may have a look on it. The pilgrimage undertaken by the Sikh community to Pakistan has great spiritual significance. It is in Pakistan where Baba Guru Nanak lived, the founder of Sikh religion. He was born here and lived here. Nankana Sahib city near Lahore hosts the oldest and the most revered of all Sikh Gurdwaras. It is in Pakistan where Maharaja Ranjit Singh, the greatest Sikh ruler, rose to glory. His birthplace remains preserved in Gujranwala city near Lahore. Sikh yatris visit their holy places in Pakistan on three occasions, one in Baisakhi in April, second on the death anniversary of Maharaja Ranjit Singh in June, and third on the birthday of Baba Guru Nanak in November every year. Opening of Kartarpur corridors by Pakistan on the 550th birthday, birth anniversary of Baba Guru Nanak, is a step that deserves appreciation. There are many other significant religious places for the followers of Buddhism in Pakistan. So religious tourism opportunities may be exploited and revenue may be earned from that. There are certain shrines of Sufi saints. We explain in these lines. There are many shrines of famous Sufi saints in Pakistan. Some of them host traditional festivals and fairs, which attract thousands of visitors annually. Apart from these fairs, thousands of persons pay visit to these shrines on daily basis. Shrine of Data Ganbaksh Hajviri Jamatullah Alayh in Lahore. Shrine of Hazrat Abdullah Shah Ghazi in Karachi, Shrine of Hazrat Lal Shabazz Qalandar in Seven, Jamshoro, and Shrine of Riduddin Ganshakar in Pakpatan are the examples of famous shrines. There are dozens of other shrines which are situated in Pakistan, and annual festivals called Urs are held on the shrines of these Sufi saints, where thousands of people come to attend. These shrines also work as shelter home for the people who have no place to stay at a particular place or city. They get food free of cost and they get some place to sleep and stay at night. A large amount of revenue is collected from the donations of these people visiting these shrines. There is a need to channelize this revenue to the government exchequer. Another point is The vast geographical landscape, we may explain it in the following lines. Pakistan has beautiful valleys, lakes, rivers, and mountains. Junction of the three of the world's most formidable ranges, Karakoram, Hindu Kush, and Himalayas, is located in Pakistan, which is an important tourist destination for trekkers and mountaineers. There are other mountain ranges in Pakistan like Safed Koh, Suleiman Mountains, Salt Range, and Kirthar Range. Five of the 14 highest peaks in the world are in Pakistan. K2 being at 8,611 meters above sea level is highest in Pakistan and the second highest mountain in the world. Pakistan has beautiful valleys, rivers, and deserts. Pakistan has four seasons around the year because of its diverse landscape, which is a great opportunity that requires to be tapped to so that tourism can be promoted. Now coming to the challenges to the tourism industry in Pakistan, one is inadequate infrastructure, road network to certain tourist spots is poor. There is threat of landsliding, airports, opportunities for air travel are limited. So access to these tourist spots is limited, and that is hampered by by lack of infrastructure. Second is the poor security situation. In June 2013, I may quote an example that at the base camp of Nanga Parbat, around 9 foreign tourists were killed by the terrorists in Pakistan, and that damaged the reputation of Pakistan as a safe country, and later on, foreign tourists stopped coming to Pakistan. So poor security situation is a big challenge. There are insufficient number of hotels and restaurants, and there are no washrooms less washrooms on the roads leading to the tourist spots. So these facilities should be built by the state. There are certain environmental challenges. When we say that tourism should be developed, then in the name of developing tourism, when the new hotel will be made, when the communication network would be built, road infrastructure would be built, that ultimately they would remove the vegetative cover. So organized efforts are needed to increase the vegetative cover in Pakistan, to plant more trees on the mountains so that environmental challenges may be overcome. So there is another threat to the local culture, that when the foreign tourists, which have certain things that are prohibited in our culture, like drinking and their dress codes, there is a threat or there is a apprehension of the clash of value system, but this threat can be overcome by inculcating in the local people an openness and understanding and tolerance of the foreign cultures. So coming to the way forward, there are certain other tourist spots which are not so popular. They may be advertised, they may be developed. Like I have quoted Gorakh Hill tourist spots in Kushab district in Isun Valley and Fort Panro, they are not more developed. There is need to develop these tourist spots and these significant places may be entered in the list of the tourist places. Infrastructure may be developed. As I have already mentioned, that there are less number of hotels and restaurants, road infrastructure, air travel. All this infrastructure need to be developed. There should be made policies for the protection of the rights of the tourist, and tourists should be pampered and they should be respected, and any incident that harasses the tourist should be taken to the task. With the help of Pakistan security forces and Pakistan police, security situation has already improved, but there is need to lead certain operations which are helpful in rooting out terrorism in Pakistan. The security situation also requires to be improved. It has already been improved, but there is always space for improvement, and preventive strategy may be adopted to prevent further acts of terrorism in Pakistan. Currently, situation is very much normal. Incidents of terrorism have significantly decreased, and Pakistan is going to be the safe country, inshallah. There should be awareness campaigns regarding the tourist opportunities in Pakistan. And last but not least, tourist facilitation centers be made functional, and they should be guiding the tourist about the best places to visit and the best places to stay. And any problems confronting the foreign or local tourist should be resolved on urgency basis. So concluding this topic, tourism has bright future in Pakistan. If the government implements the suggestion given in the presentation, tourism will have many advantages for Pakistan. With this, I would say thanks to all of you for viewing this. I will be here soon with new topic, and hope you are benefiting from this series. Thank you, Allah Hafiz.